Black Box, okay? So Black Box, what you can do is at the top, there's a tools bar here, and you can drop it down, and there's a product research section. And Black Box is our main tool for product research. So there's a bunch of different tabs, and I'm going to highlight the products tab, the keywords tab, and the product targeting tabs. So the first one I'll talk about is just products. So in products, the first thing you want to do is you want to choose different categories. So I like to choose a few different ones. Now you can choose all of them, but these are the kind of the categories where you would want to sell products in. So I've got kitchen and dining, pet supplies, sports and outdoor, or maybe I'll do tools and home improvement. You can choose whatever you want there, but you definitely need to choose some categories. You want to choose a sales price as well. And so I always do 25 to 90, but I really don't like to go lower than $25 because of margins, and you just want to make money. So I look for products that are higher priced than $25. I also like to see things that are, selling a good amount of money every month. So I like to start off with a minimum of 10,000 in revenue for a product. But all of these filters on here, you can use them and use them in different combinations. And that's kind of the beauty about this tool, is that you can get in here and you can start playing around with the filters. And once you start doing that, you'll start saying, oh, maybe if I put this number in here, maybe I should do that. And it'll change the results that you get every time. And that way you're not getting the same thing that maybe everyone else is doing. And a lot of people have gotten really good at Black Box. And that's kind of the secret sauce, is just, getting into the tool and playing around with it. And something that I want to point out is there is a learn button up at the top right here. So if you forget anything that I'm saying in this presentation, you can actually go into each tool, and we have learn buttons for every single tool that's on here. So you can learn individually how to use these tools, so you don't get, too overwhelmed. But another thing is reviews. Okay. So review the ratings. Sometimes I like to either do a minimum review count or a review rating. So you can do both. Sometimes I like to look for products that are selling well, but they have a low review rating, because then maybe I can get and make the product a little bit better. So I have a maximum of a 3.5 rating here. Maybe I'll do a maximum of 50 reviews. And then sometimes I also like to look at small standard size, because they have the lowest fees for Amazon. So that's kind of where I like to fit in there. You can do a listing age. Some people put like a maximum of 3 months, because then you could see, something that's up and coming that's just started selling. So there's a lot of different ways that you can utilize these different filters, but I'll just start with that. And what's going to happen is we see a bunch of results of potential product ideas here. So we've got, some table runners. We've got a bunch of different products here. So you can look at each one differently and individually. So let's look at this dog soother thing. I like pet products. So you can take a look at this. You've got a, a 3.1. So what you can do is take a look at the ratings, and you can see why. Maybe see it's too tiny, so they think they're not getting enough product. So maybe the product is really good, but they don't, like how small it is. So that's something to think about. You can also go in here and edit the filters if you want to. So it's not all is not lost if you want to change the filters. So to get more, I'm going to change that maximum of 50 reviews. Now, a maximum of 50 reviews would just mean that maybe it's a less competitive, because if something has thousands of reviews, it's going to be, a little harder to break into. But I want to see if we can get some more products, so we can
That
get one that I
first
can
one
show
was
you an
cool, Gary, I
example.
think. It's
Which
I'm
one?
not sure. The first
Oh,
one
this one?
was
Okay,
yeah,
cool. This
something
socket wrench?
cool,
Cool.
looks really, simple, and seems like it's bringing pretty good revenue. Not many reviews. I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So let's take a look at that. So yeah, it has, let's see, 17,000 a month, which is good. The reviews are a 3.5. So we got to see what's going on there. $29.99. I like that price. And you know what? You're right. It's a small, like probably not too expensive to make this. It's a socket wrench. Okay. So let's see what the reviews say. You can take a look. And something cool about Helium 10 is we have this extension here. And what you can do is you can click on review insights, and it's going to pull all the reviews here, and it's going to help you analyze them. So you can do a review analysis. You can actually do a review of all the questions that people are asking. So it gives you a good idea about what customers are looking for, what questions they have, and all of that. So let's see here. Too small. So it's too small would be a reason. It looks like people would not recommend this, maybe would not stay attached. So you get a really good idea of maybe what's going wrong with this particular tool. I'm not really as familiar with tools, but you can go ahead and solve all of these issues and create a better product.